And her house is so spacious and clean and sparkly. Drive this car, have this drink, buy this product. And of all the products that I think is the best example is Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola because they even call it the Coca-Cola culture. Coca-Cola is the symbol of America, symbol of consumerism, symbol of the American way of life. Coca-Cola. They say that more people drink Coca-Cola than they do water. Coca-Cola. And then you see again on the television the advertisements. It tells you Coke is the real thing. Coke is it. Coke is life. So what do you see in this advertisement? You see this man drinking Coca-Cola. It's hot. And he's drinking this nice, cool, ice-cool Coke. And this man is so perfect. He is so beautiful. His muscles are rippling. You can count his six-pack on his stomach. And there he is. He's drinking his nice, cool, ice-cool Coke. And then you get a shot of this woman. Blonde, white, well she's brown, but she's brown-white, if you know what I mean. The right type of brown, okay? So there she is, the brown-white woman, and she is beautiful. Again, no fat, 34, 32, I don't know the statistics, right? There she is, right? Again, she is drinking the nice, cool, ice, cool Coke. And you look at that and you say, yeah. You say, I want some of that. What do you want? What do you want some of? You want some of that caramel-colored carbonated water? No! You want some of that beautiful man and that beautiful woman. That's what you want. And so there you see them in the advertisement. This man and this woman, young, new, vile, beautiful. Look, you couldn't get any fat on them, right? But you know it's a big lie. It's a big lie. Because the reality is, if you drink Coca-Cola, you get fat. You don't get thin and young and beautiful and brown. You get fat. Coca-Cola makes you fat. It doesn't make you young and beautiful. But you see people, they're not really selling you a drink. They're selling you a lifestyle. They're selling you an ideology. They're selling you a way of thinking. That's what they're selling to you. And that's across the board. That is across the board. That's how it goes. And that's it. They want to convert the world to their religion. At this present time, we have 17%. 17% of the world population consuming 70% of its resources. In other words, 70% of the world's food, oil, chemicals, minerals, water, everything, the world's resources, 70% of it is being consumed by 17% of its population. What 17% is that? That is the 17% that lives in Canada, in the United States of America, and in the Western European countries. That's why they call them the consumer society. People are starving and dying all over the world. Yet in America, you cannot see hardly a thin person. This is the thing. consume, consume, buy, buy, purchase, purchase. And there's always the latest thing with the latest gadget that you have to get. Whether it's a computer, now your Pentium 2, DMX, well, MMX they call it, right? 200 megahertz is out of date because now they bought the Pentium 3.5 triple XD 500 megahertz and you think that your computer is slow. So you have to buy the next one. The next stereo comes out with a mega bass extra super hooper duper on it. Okay? So wait a minute, that's not good enough. My bass hooper, I need an extra bass hooper duper super. Right? Your gym shoes are not good enough anymore because you can't stick a little pump in and pump them up. You want the pump up one. You want to be like Michael Jordan flying through the air and dunking his basketball or whatever. So this is the thing. What they're telling you is buy, buy, buy. Buy, buy, get this, get that. What you've got is not good enough anymore. We have advanced technologically so fantastic you must get the new product. And for this thing, these sneakers, they're good. They haven't even, you know, they even like worn out of the blood. They sit in the bottom of the drawer and they want the next one. Maybe they just get thrown away. Consumer society. And they don't even know where to throw their rubbish anymore. This is what's taking place. But you know, the thing is that this is destroying our world. Because these people who do this, they never seem to be happy. They're never happy. The more they buy, the more they want. And they never get enough. They never get enough. They're never happy with what they've got. And they always have to have more and more and more and more. And this is what they want to convert the world to. But in fact, it can't work. If 17% are consuming 70% of the world's resources, if 100% of the world was converted to this way of living, then what would happen? So, I said, they want to convert the world, surely they do. Because the more people they get buying, consuming, the more money it is for them. And they have, as I told you, their books, their theologians, their priests, they have their theology. In other words, they have already explained the meaning of life, according to them. According to them, the meaning of life is this. They have now figured out that we are descended from monkeys. Right? No, actually they say that to be accurate, we and monkeys are descended from a common primate. That's what they say. It's called the theory of evolution. The theory of evolution tells us that we have evolved from this monkey animal. Now, you know, you may find it more difficult to accept in the case of Mr. Clinton or some other particular people that they have evolved from such creatures, but concerning myself, I don't think so. However, it's not merely a scientific theory. It is not merely a scientific theory. You see, the theory of evolution is very central and important to their whole attitude and their whole understanding of their consumer society. Why? Because you know what they're saying is this. Look, basically, we are animals. You and me are just advanced monkeys. But basically, we are monkeys. So what makes a monkey a happy monkey? Yeah. How do you get a monkey to be a happy monkey? You give a man monkey a woman monkey? Or you give a woman monkey a man monkey? Give the monkey some bananas. Right? Keep the monkey safe from the predators and from the harmful effects of the